What's going on, guys? Bill's here from Achievement Land, and I'm here with an 100% achievement walkthrough for the game Wick, which is coming to Xbox One December 21st, 2016 for a price of $9.99. And this game was developed and published by Hellbent Games. So this is a pretty cool survival horror game. It's very similar to Emily Wants to Play. You have to survive each hour. This game is a little harder than that, though. The first couple hours are pretty simple, but the 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. are the hardest. The last 5 a.m. actually isn't too bad. So I'm going to go through this game. There's extra modes that you unlock too. There's the No Way Out mode, and then there's the secret game. The No Way Out is called Last Year as well. You unlock that from finding collectibles in the first 3 hours. So I'm going to show you all the landmarks so you understand where to go in this game. You know how to get around. Then I'm going to go through the collectibles and the miscellaneous achievements you can get throughout the hours. Then I'll go over the two extra games. So as we go through, we're going to go through the drawings as well. There's 6 drawings. These are the evidence. You'll get them as you play through. There's one for at the end of the game when you beat 5 a.m. And these are the collectibles. So first, I'm going to go to the No Way Out mode. You're not going to have this unlocked at the beginning. You got to get 3 collectibles to unlock this mode. But the thing in this mode is you can actually go around and walk around without anybody chasing you. So if you want to learn the area, this is a good mode to use. So over here is the graveyard. Right by the graveyard, if you follow the fence down here, is the water tower. You could see it if you look up.
It's like a blast of the past. Water tower.
It's right in the corner. Right by the water tower, if you follow the fence this way, because it's in the corner, the bus is here. And right by the bus is the camp sign. One of the collectibles is right by the camp sign, so it's good to know that. Alright, moving along. When you first enter the No Way Out DLC, when you come through the gate, you're going to go right by the bus, so you want to go to the right over here to get to the graveyard. But if you go straight,
sparkly over there,
on the other side, opposite the water tower, there's a cabin. There's also a campfire that's in between them, between the bus and the cabin. The campfire is the only thing I have trouble finding sometimes. But I'll show you where it is. Here's the cabin here, or the woodshed it's called. Right over here next to it, there's some trees. One of these trees over here is where there's going to be a collectible show up. That's the cracked mask. Now, if you go from the cabin and you walk straight ahead, going towards the bus. If you reach the bus, you went too far. The campfire is over here somewhere in between.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
It's not that close to the fence, so I don't know why I'm looking over this way. Oh, there's the bus. See, I went too far. Now, head over this way. Kind of towards the middle. There it is. You'll find these tree logs on the ground, and there's the campfire. Alright. Now, this is the way back to the woodshed.
Come on, don't fail me now.
Oh, it's a lot closer than I thought it was. Alright, now from the woodshed, you can actually see the woodshed. You can see the fireplace in the middle. This is a good landmark to know. You can reach all the other spots from here. Now, if you go to the back of this fireplace here, and you walk straight ahead, You're gonna reach our next landmark, the bridge.
That does not look safe.
That does not look safe.
Really, flashlight? Really?
One side of the bridge, if you go straight, it will take you to the fireplace. And that's also the middle of the map. The other side here will take you to the fence. And now if you follow this fence down, if you go left when you get off and follow it down, you're going to reach the well, which will be our next landmark.
Ooh, horror movie 101.
There's one more landmark to go over. And the way to get there, a good way to know where it is having the bridge over here, having it behind you, and having the fence on your right. You want to just follow the path down, and you'll see a rock right over here, a big rock. This is called the Nope Rock. There's a collectible here, and there's also another achievement that you get here, which we'll go over later on. There's one other landmark that I forgot to go over, and that's the couch. But it's not as important as the other landmarks, but I'll show it later on when we get to the collectible there. Alright, so let's start the game. First hour, midnight. There's a bunch of achievements that are the easiest to get on midnight. One of them is everyone dies. You have to get on midnight. You have to die in the first hour. Lights on is where you gotta always stay in the light. You gotta keep a candle with you and transfer the light to another candle. Make sure your candle doesn't go out without any other candles around. So just keep going from candle to candle, and you can even wait by the next candle till yours is like almost done and then light the next one. Then the other one is Matchstick Man, where you gotta just use matches the whole time, don't pick up any candles. You can wait by the first candle because the guy won't come for a while. Just wait till it dies out just so you have some light. And then just walk around and use matches very sparingly though, don't use them too much. But I would definitely recommend doing Lights On and Matchstick Man in midnight because it's the easiest and shortest one. Alright, so we got our first drawing here, number 1 out of 6. There's also another drawing a little bit further up here on the next tree. So we got 2 out of 6 drawings now. Alright, moving along here, we're gonna get our first collectible. The fireplace is right in front over here. And this is where our collectible is. Right on the fireplace. Nope, I want to take that. Our next collectible is at the campfire, but I'm going to head over to the woodshed because I know where that is very easily. And I'll get a candle in here. There usually is one in here. Not always, but most of the time. And then just go out the door and walk straight, and you should be able to reach the campfire like I showed earlier. There we go, pretty easy. And there's our next collectible. Alright, so now we're gonna get our third collectible, which is at the well. You can head to the fireplace and then go in the back of it and go straight, and it will take you to the bridge. And then when you get on the bridge, you can just jump off the left side. Or you can go straight to the fence and go left, either way. This will take you over to the well. Now before I get the last collectible, there's another achievement that's easy to get on midnight. And that's the achievement called Well, Well, Well. You have to put 3 candles lit on top of the well. Now on midnight, a lot of times there's a candle on the well already. The hardest part, I think, is getting them on there. Because sometimes you put them down and it doesn't go on. Or you try to put it down and you pick up another. So you want to get 3 candles on there. You should put down 2 and then light the other one with your candle you're holding. You can even look up and put them down. It's kind of better so you don't pick them up. Now at midnight, a lot of times there's a candle on the well. And there's a candle on the bridge. And then there's the candle you're holding. So if you're quick enough, you just go right to the well. should be able to do that, and you can get your achievement. Now you can grab your last collectible. That bell noise signifies that you're halfway through. Then you'll hear another bell at the end when it's over. Alright, so we got all our collectibles for the first hour. There's still one more collectible we have to get, and that's to unlock the No Way Out game. There's three you have to get, one in midnight, one in 1 a.m., and one in 2 a.m. Now the one that's here in the midnight hour is the one that's on the couch. And to get to the couch, it's basically on the opposite side of the well. So if you're on the bridge and you're going towards the fence, if you go left, you go towards the well. If you go right, you go towards the couch. In the corner, there's going to be the rock. So when you hit the rock, you go right and it's right by there. So this is going right from the bridge. This is the rock here. You're going to want to know about that rock as well later on. There's 9 buttons you have to press, and that rock is one of the buttons. Oh nice, he blew up my candle. That's the one annoying thing if you're going for the lights on achievement. Sometimes they blow out your candle. That's why it's best to go for the lights on achievement in the midnight hour, because it's the shortest, and that rarely happens where they blow it out. It happens more when Lily and the girls are around. Alright, so this is the couch. Like I said, it's right by the rock. And that's your first No Way Out collectible. You also see in the bottom left it said unlocked evidence. There's 100% achievement in this game, so you gotta unlock all the evidence and get all the other achievements. There's one more achievement you can get in the midnight hour, and that's called Schooled. Just keep going in and out of the bus until Tim spawns in it, and as soon as you see him in there, just run away. And once you're clear from him, the achievement will pop. And there's the bell that signals the end here. And there's the achievement for surviving the first hour.
Private property? Wait, someone actually lives up there?
Alright, let's go to 1 a.m. Now this time, you have to deal with Tim and Lillian. She's basically just like Tim, but she has a bigger attack distance. Here's drawing number 3. There's only one in this hour. Now the first collectible is pretty close here. Right by these double trees is the nope rock. You start right by it, so just go over here and circle around until you see the little skull. Now the next is under the bridge. You can head over to the fence if you want and follow down. The fence should be on your left side. Under the bridge is the brace. Our last collectible is at the water tower. Now you want to go all the way straight and to the right in the back corner by the school bus. And there's the cross. Now we have all the collectibles in the 1 a.m. hour. There's still one more collectible to get for the No Way Out DLC, which is actually right by the water tower. It's in the graveyard. No, go away. But of course I can't get over there easily because Tim and Lillian want to block me. Just follow the fence down here from the water tower. And you'll see the fence will dip in, and that's where the graveyard is. Here we go. And it's on the 5th grave. No, go away, Lillian. Alright, now that she's gone, like I said, it's on the 5th grave, the last one to the right, which is Caleb's grave. Now we have No Way Out collectible number 2.
And when you found out it's real, then our channel is going to blow up. That can finally be our ticket out of this shithole.
Now you just want to stay alive until the bells ring and you'll have your achievement for the second hour, which is 1 a.m. Alright, so let's start 2 a.m. There's two drawings in this one. Drawing number 4. I accidentally missed the drawing, so I had to go back after I got the next drawing. So I got the achievement here. But this is only going to be your 5th one here. And both of these are at the beginning. This one is just behind you. So I got my achievement here, but you're going to get it on the next level, the next hour. Now, you're going to start right by the bridge here. And that's where your first collectible is. So you want to just go up here. You can go up and climb the rock and go on the bridge. And nope, it's on the other side. And there's the bucket. Collectible number 1.
Jack and Jill went up the hill, fetch a pail of water. Jack fell down and broke his bone. Jill came tumbling after.
Now follow the bridge straight off, and you'll reach the fireplace, and that's where you're going to get your next collectible, which is on the rocks here, right by the fireplace. In this hour, there's 2 new guys that are introduced. There's Tom, who's the twin brother of Tim. And Tom, you just gotta look away from him. And there's also Benjamin, who's like a big fat kid that walks around, that chases you, and you gotta drop your light. Now, Tom, when you go in this room sometimes, Tom comes in here with you, and the door shuts. All you gotta do is not look at him. You can stare up or stare down, and wait until the door opens, and you'll get the achievement called Claustrophobia. So you want to do that on this hour, the 2 a.m. You can just keep going in and out of the shack. Go in and then run away, maybe towards the fireplace, and then run back. And eventually it will trigger. The last collectible here is right on the tree, right by the woodshed, or the cabin, whatever you want to call it. And that's your achievement. Now we still have one more collectible to get, and that's for the No Way Out game. This will be the last one, and then you'll have it unlocked. It's right by the bus. I went in the bus to get a candle. There usually is one in there. But right by the bus and right by the sign, there's the gate over here. And there's a cracked phone on the ground. And that's the No Way Out collectible, your last one. Which will give you an achievement and also unlock evidence. Now you'll be able to play the No Way Out mode as well. And you can walk around freely like I did at the beginning of this video, and you can learn the landmarks if you like. You won't have to worry about any guys chasing you until you trigger the game in the graveyard. So there's one more achievement here that you can get in this hour, and it's called the Rock of Nope. You can get it in a couple other hours too, the one that has Lillian, but when you go over to the rock, the same one that has the first collectible in the 1 a.m. hour, when you go over there, you should hear her crying. You can see her glow. You can go behind the rock like I did. You'll see her. And as soon as you see her, just run out of there. And once you're gone from her, you'll get your achievement. And I also got the achievement for beating the hour, too.
We haven't hung out since junior high when he joined some website and stopped caring about real life.
Alright, so on to the next hour. 3 a.m. Right here in the beginning, you're going to get your last drawing. Number 6. You'll get your achievement after picking this up. I actually got it on number 5 because I missed it and I had to go back. Alright, before we do the collectibles in this hour, I'm going to show you 2 miscellaneous achievements that are easy to get in this hour. Now the first one is called Toasty. Now as soon as you start this hour, you want to grab the candle, turn around, and head over to the fireplace. The fireplace will be right by you. Now this one is a random event that happens when you enter this area, the fireplace. Doesn't happen that often, but I got it to trigger in this hour, 3 a.m. most of the time. So what you can do is just go into the fireplace area, go towards the cabin, and then just come back. And it should happen. If it doesn't, just keep trying, or you can restart the hour. After the little cutscene happens, you'll get your achievement. Now there's another achievement that you can get right at the beginning of this hour as well, and it's called A Bridge to Fear. Now you have to do it in this hour. You can do another ones too, but this one I find the easiest. You have to do it in an hour that has Tim and Tom in it, and 3 a.m. is the first one that has both of them in it. So what you want to do is walk on the bridge and then walk off it and then walk back on. You'll hear them and you turn around and you'll see them. As you're turning around, they're going to keep getting closer to you. Once they get a little bit closer, jump off the bridge and you'll get your achievement. It's really not that bad. All right, now let's start with the collectibles. Going back to the beginning, got the bridge in front of you. You're going to want to turn around. You want to head towards the fireplace and just keep going straight. We're going to go over to the graveyard first. Get out of here, Tom. So you want to pass the fireplace. You're going to go by the cabin. And then you can just follow the fence down until you reach the graveyard. Alright, here's the graveyard. And this one is going to be on the third one, Lillian's grave. So now we're going to head to the next collectible, which is on the bus. Going to head this way to the left when you leave the grave. Thought I heard something behind me. Sometimes you turn around and you just see Tim or Tom just standing behind you. So you're going to head this way towards the water tower. No, my candle. Hopefully there'll be a candle on the bus like there usually is. Now you make a right at the water tower and that's where the bus is. Yay, candle. And right on the front seat here, right where it says Tom, is your second collectible. Third collectible is right in front of the bus, but of course Tim is blocking it. Oh, there's Tom. Oh, man, he got me. All right. Back at the bus here. Now, right in front of the bus door is the camp sign, and that's where your third collectible is. And there's the achievement. Now, you just have to survive. This hour is kind of tricky. 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. are the worst, I think. 3 a.m. you have to worry about Tim and Tom, and Benjamin's walking around, and also Khalib's in that hour. That's where he gets introduced. He digs around and he pops up and chases you. So, and Tim is like really hard on that one. I don't know why. Now, 4 a.m. you have to deal with all of them. And 4 a.m. is the longest of them all. So let's do the collectibles here. You want to go over and head over to the bridge. Get the shoe for your first collectible. Now, we gotta go to the shed cabin thing for the next collectible. So when you get off the bridge, you wanna head to the left a little bit. You can follow this path that will take you right to it. Right in here is the lantern, collectible number 2. Now sometimes when you enter the cabin, the door will shut. If you have Tom in here with you, just don't look at him look up at the ceiling or the floor, and then when the door opens and you walk out, you'll get the claustrophobia achievement, but sometimes he's not in there with you. It just shuts by itself, so you won't get the achievement then. Alright, now follow it down the fence. Just follow it straight down, follow the fence, and our next collectible is at the water tower. It's right in front when you get there, if you're following the fence. It's the gas mask. Now that's all the collectibles. There's no collectibles in the last hour in 5 a.m. Sometimes Lillian just teleports you places. So I got one more achievement in this hour. You can get it in a couple different hours. You just need to have Benjamin in it. You can also get it in the New Way Out game. I just kind of got lucky here and got it in this hour. But all you have to do is escape Benny when he's chasing you. You'll see your screen kind of shake a little bit and rumble when he's chasing you. He's the fat kid. He's kind of hard to get away from, but what you want to do is put your candle on the ground, because that kind of distracts him. He won't chase you anymore. Sometimes he still will, but I like to run through trees too. That kind of messes him up. And then once you're gone from him, you'll get your achievement. Benny, go back to sleep. Alright, so that's all the collectibles and everything from the main game. All you have to do is beat 4 a.m. and 5 a.m. You'll get evidence for beating 5 a.m. too. So now we're going to go over to No Way Out. Now in this one, there's a little like intro scene. And you're going to go into this area. Now you want to walk around.
What's up, Doc?
He's going to say stuff as you go to certain things. There's only like 5 or 6 things you have to go to. There's the boat, the dock, there's an outhouse, the map, a couple cabins. After you walk around and search the area, you want to go into the third cabin, the one with the door open, and then you'll get your achievement for searching everything in the camp, exploring everything. Now there's a key here. This opens up the gate, and you'll go into the area that you are in the main game. Now I'm going to bring it back because I'm going to show you the birds. There's an achievement for shooing away 7 birds, and you can actually skip this beginning area once you've done it once. And if you skip it, you can't get the bird achievement, because you can only get 5 birds as you're playing the No Way Out game. But if you go in the beginning area, there's 3 birds. So there's one on the first cabin. There's another bird here on the map. You just go towards them and they'll fly away. Now also with the key, sometimes it's not in the main spot, in the regular spot. Just turn around and it'll be on the floor. I've only seen it in those 2 spots. Most of the time, it's in the first spot I showed you. Now, once you get the key, you just go back towards the fence, and there'll be a gate. And also on the gate will be your 3rd bird.
Oh, shit.
Bird number 3. And then when you go in this gate, you'll be right by the camp sign and the bus. Now the objective of this game is it will give you 5 random collectibles, and you gotta put them away, like where you get them from, the same spots that you got them in the main game. Every time you bring one of them back to, there'll be a bird there. So holy, I've already got 3 birds, now I just need 4 more, and then I'll have the 7 bird achievement.
How the hell is a candle here?
Now when you get to the grave here, once you get over here, the game's gonna start. It will show you the collectibles that you have to put back. There's one for each of the characters, basically. That's why it's one on each grave. The best thing to do is work left to right. The first one is Tim, the second one is Tom, the third one is Lillian, 4th is Benjamin, and 5 is Caleb. When you pick up their collectible and you go to return it, that's going to make them active. So I got the first one here, which is Tim's gas mask. And there's the bird. So I got 4 birds now. This game mode is actually not too hard. I didn't find it too difficult. You just gotta keep going back and putting the collectibles away. The guys, they act a little bit different than the main game. Not too much difference. Caleb's a little different. In the main game, he digs around and stays on the ground more. In this one, he's up more. He jumps out and chases you. That's why I like to save him for last, because he's kind of difficult in this one. So now we're going to put away Tom's. This is in the bus. There's a bird over here. That's my fifth bird now. Get a new candle.
There's another one, Don.
Tom is one of the easiest guys to avoid. You're not safe at the graveyard either when you get over here. They can attack you, so you gotta be careful. Now this is Lillian's collectible, so she's gonna be active now.
I would assume this goes here.
You should know where all the collectibles are at this point. But I'll write them down in the description where they all go, just in case. Now, I made the mistake of grabbing Calves first, but I actually get an achievement here for Dig This. And that's for getting away from Caleb when he comes up from underground. You can get this in the main game, but it's a little easier in this mode because he comes up more and he goes after you more, so you have a better chance of getting it in this mode. But if you want, you can get it in 3 a.m. You'll see him digging around and you just run away once he pops up. Now I'm going to get the bird achievement here, since I got 3 in the beginning area. And then I did 3 of the collectibles so far and shoot away birds.
Oh, shit.
So this will be the 7th. You don't even see the bird, but I got close enough and he flew away. Nevermore. You also get evidence for every time you put back one of the guy's collectibles for the first time.
An old lantern.
So you'll get 5 evidence, you know, 1 for each guy. Now I died there, so I had to go back, but I skipped the beginning here and I'm doing it the right way by doing going left to right and putting back Benjamin's thing first. Benjamin is a harder guy, but he doesn't come out as much as Caleb does. Caleb is very active in this mode. So that's why I recommend going left to right and doing them in that order. So now all I have to do is the last one here. The trophy, which is actually pretty close by. It's right by the bus, the camp sign. Once you put down the 5th collectible, all the kids will disappear for the time being. No, my candle. There we go, right here. Get it down.
All done.
All right, now they're all gone, but it's not over yet. You're gonna get the achievement, Laid to Rest. But now we have to get back to the cabin. I wish there was a candle over here, but there's not. Alright, so we gotta get back to the cabin that you got the key in. And once you go through this gate, the guys are gonna start going after you.
Bloody hell! Oh, why'd I do that?
So just run straight. And avoid all the guys. Be very careful. I almost got stuck there. Now it's the 3rd cabin on the right. You'll see the door open, run in, and you're safe.
No way out. What does that mean?
You also unlock evidence too. After watching that little cutscene here at the end, you'll get your achievement. There we go. Now we have a couple more things to go over in the No Way Out DLC. There's a couple more achievements and evidence. When you walk by the campfire, sometimes you'll get this event to trigger where it lights up in flames. That's actually one of the evidence you need.
Haven't you talked to Papa?
And then there's two more. One, you'll see the mom flying around. She's usually in front of the bridge, but she can be in some other spots too. You just walk up to her, and then she'll scream at you. You'll get another evidence, and you also get an achievement. Then, if you go over by the shed cabin thing, sometimes when you walk into it, it triggers an event with the dad. Hanging out with dad. And you'll get some more evidence, and you'll also get another achievement. Now there's two more achievements that you can get only in this mode. The next one is hide and seek. Now you want to start the game and just grab the collectible in the middle, the third grave, which is Lillian's. You want to get her active and after you. You can go and put the collectible down. Once you do that, you want to put your candle down. You need to be in the dark. Now, this is a random event, but it usually happens when you don't have a candle on you and you have Lillian after you. She's gonna say that she wants to play a game, which is hide and seek. Then she'll start counting down, and you need to get inside the bus or inside the cabin. So once you hear her talking and counting down, just make your way to the cabin or bus as fast as you can and just stay inside until she's done counting. Once you're safe, you'll get your achievement. Now there's one more achievement to get in this mode, and this one is kind of tricky to get to happen. You have to go to the church, and the way to get to the church is by having the twins after you. So what you want to do is start this mode, and you want to do Tim, you want to put his collectible away, and then you want to do Tom, put his collectible away. Tim is the first grave all the way to the left, and then Tom is right next to him. He's the second grave. Now, once you do both of the collectibles and put them away, just run around in the area and just don't have a light on you. You can use the matches if you want, but when you're running around, there's a chance that they'll teleport you into the church. So once you get in here, you just walk behind the podium and you just watch the cutscene. And then after it's done, you'll get your achievement.
Depart, then, transgressor. Depart, seducer, full of lies and cunning, foe of virtue, persecutor of the innocent. Give way, abominable creature. Give way, you monster. I cast you forth into the outer darkness, where everlasting ruin awaits you.
Such nice kids. After that cutscene, you'll get your achievement, and you'll also unlock evidence, which goes towards your 100% achievement. Alright, now we're done with the No Way Out game. Alright, so now we're going to unlock the secret minigame. And to do it, you got to press 9 buttons. You could do it in any of the hours of the game. We're going to do it at midnight, since it's the easiest. There's only Tim running around, so you don't have to worry that much. The first one's over here in the corner, the rock. The one that I told you about earlier in this video. That's by the couch. I just come over to this rock, this little rock jutting out, and you push it in, and that's the first button. After the rock, you're going to want to turn left and just follow it down, and you're gonna get to the bridge. It's on this side of the bridge. You wanna go over here and you press this little button for number 2. For the next one, we're gonna go over to the fireplace. On the left side of the fireplace over here, by these stones, push it in, and that's button number 3. You could do these in any order. I'm just showing you the way that I went. Now you wanna head over here to the shed for button number 4. Now you want to go right and follow it down by the fence. Our next one's going to be in the graveyard. Right over here. The first grave, Tim's grave. You want to go behind it. Oh, there's Tim. He might be mad I'm going to his grave. He's not too bad because this is the first hour. You just run around and he's gone. Little button on the back here. Press that. Now our next one is going to be over at the water tower. Over on the side here, there's a little button. Press that for number 6. Next, we're going to head straight over to the bus, and you're going to press in the front left wheel for our next button. Of course, there's no candle there when you need one. Alright, back over by the middle where the fireplace is, right next to it, there's some rocks over here. It's like a flat rock with 2 big pieces of rocks on it. It's not this one. Turn around. It's this little one right here. You push it in. And now we have one more button to press, which is at the campfire. The campfire is in between the bus and the shed. Sometimes tricky to find. Just walk around and look for the logs laying down on the ground. Get out of here, Tim. There's the bus. You get to the bus, you gone too far. There we go. Now the last button is on one of the logs. It's a little piece coming out. And here it is. Press it. Once you press your 9th button, it will take you by the fireplace, give you your achievement, and then it's going to bring you to the secret game. Alright, so this should be the last thing here. The secret game here is called Wick Butt. It's kind of like Slender Man. After completing this game, you should get your achievement for this and also for 100% completion if you've been following this whole video. So make sure you complete all the hours of the night, complete all the miscellaneous achievements in the regular game and the no way out mode, and collect all the evidence which you'll get from doing all the other achievements and a couple other things that are covered in this video. But this is Wick Butt. It's just like Slender Man. You have to go around and collect 7 pages. And you kind of want to be fast. I think the longer you take, the more active he is, like going after you. You don't want to look at him either, or he'll get closer to you. So you have to collect 7 pages. They're not always in the same spot. This is one of the spots it could be in. I'm going to walk around for the rest of this video and show you where the pages are sometimes. I didn't get them all in this run, but just so you can have a little idea of where to go. You just want to really go around the edges and you'll see them. And then there's a couple spots in the middle to get them. So I'm going to let this video play out. You can see where I went to get the pages. I didn't get them all. I got like 6, I think, out of 7 before Wickbuck got me. But hopefully this will help you. And I hope this whole video helped you guys get all the achievements. I'm going to link in the description some other stuff that can help you guys. And thanks for watching, guys. If you want to see more achievement reviews, achievement guides, and previews, check out the site achievementland.com and also the YouTube Achievement Land. Thanks for watching and good luck. Ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch.